Good afternoon, friends at Bookworms. This is Sia, and we're live right here at the Dipsloot Gym Park, where we are celebrating National Water Week. And with me here today, I'm with one of the stakeholders from Outlook Foundation, Ntate Sekgomotse Kelefetswe. Did I say it right? Yes, Sekgomotse Kelefetswe. How are you, sir?
I'm okay. How are you, Melia?
I'm good, good. So tell me, what is it that actually prompted you to take part in this initiative?
I think the passion, it's what is the bottom line for me to be partaking in this. Secondly, the stakeholders that we work with, we are concerned about the state of the country, especially in terms of the water resources. So we want to take message to the community to enable the community to be aware of the constraints about the issues surrounding water. Hence, we are here in Dipsloot, next to one of the streams, to be able to demonstrate what you're talking about.
Okay. And so far, what's your perception on how things have taken place so far?
It's quite interesting to see that the primary school learners have already got the knowledge about how to conserve water. These kids have demonstrated to us how important it is to take the water resources seriously. And secondly, we realized, especially through the question and answer sessions that they were having with Water Research Commission, plus the Rond Water young professionals, the kids, they show and display a lot of knowledge. Whatever we were presenting to them, actually we realized that we're just rehearsing what they know. So it looks like we managed to reach our expectation, especially with the learners.
Okay. So I understand that the National Water Week started running from the 18th and it will end on the 25th of March. With that being said, is this the only project that you will be running, or are there more that people can anticipate?
I think this was the only project that we do publicly. Other projects, I think it has been interventions where we go and educate the communities about how to save water, basic savings water skills within the household. With us, we had Water Research Commission who were launching the book about the household saving water, methodologies. That book we're still going to keep on distributing and issuing at the workplaces and every corner in South Africa to make sure that everybody joins us in this initiative. So this is not a once-off event, it's a forever event. But today is just to make it live, to go to
If you don't have any water, what happens? You can flush, you can cook. What happens? There is no life. So that's why it's very important that as individuals, young as you are, start growing by learning the attitude of conserving water, of taking care of these precious resources. When you play next to the rivers, this toys or this litter that we have has to go to the bins. You can see they even have provided a bin here. We don't throw anywhere else, we throw in the bin. Otherwise, you throw in the rivers, what happens? We pollute the stream. When they need to take water to clean it so that you can drink water, it's useless because it's very dirty. Can you see that? So it's very important that as young as you are, you learn to conserve water and you take this lesson and do what? Share it with others. No use having knowledge and you sit about Kayola. Go and share with others at school, at home, in your community. Don't encourage any wrong use or any misuse of water resources, ne? Because we need to save every drop. I need to say every liter, every drop.
Johannesburg Water is a company that is responsible of providing water and sanitation services. Now here's the sanitation part of the team. It's your grey water. We treat your grey water. Grey water, we mean amanzi lawa, no flush in the toilet, amanzi ben kezi zicha ngao, amanzi ben washama tegi ngao. And it's more school in washama soyuz. Mokia to treat the training. So Mokia lapo is grey water, la amanzi lawa, as a gift. Now it's your water, we are responsible of treating that water. So it's a provider and clean water and treat the grey water. Okay? That is our job. Now this is what happens. thina simujobe bota asina manzi amanzi siwathenga kurendo erendo water iwathatha kwi-department of water because it's a precious resource that we don't have as now. We don't have South Africa, it's a water scarce country. We understand the money, it's a water scarce country. It's a possibility.
Pollution can break the skin of water, do you understand?
Yes.
Okay. You're gonna use the baby powder, you all know a baby powder,
yes? Yes.
Okay. Baby powder will represent the skin of the water. Okay, you understand that?
Okay.
So now, let's say how do this pollution break the water skin?
Okay.
One has to dip his thumb there. Dip your thumb.
Okay.
Apply some soap. And then what you need to do now? Don't dip your thumb here. You touch. Just touch.
What happens? Okay, what happens? You also again.
Yes.
What happens?
The skin is moving.
The skin got broken. Okay. Why? What do you think is the main cause? Is this finger? Is it his finger? What is it?
So,
the soap.
Okay.
The soap came as a pollution and it raised the skin of the water. So what are we trying to teach you? Let's save our water. Let's protect our water. We understand? They are very valuable for us. Okay. And another thing that you need to understand is that Gauteng province, we are a semi-arid province in South Africa. What does that mean? It means that we do not have a lot of water.
Dr. Nontlantla.
Sanibonani? Sanibonani? Ngiyabonga mqhubi uhlelo and ngiyabonga ku-ward councillor kusamukela. Igama lami nginguNonhlanhla wakaKhanebayila. Ngibuya kwinkampani ethiwa i-Water Research Commission. I-Water Research Commission yinkampani eyenza ucwaningo ngamanzi. We do research on water, so if you want, if there's something that you want to know about water, ungangibuza and ngiyokuphendula. So, but before ngiqhubeke, ngifuna ukubonga nabo bonke abalana, and also thank Johannesburg City Parks, Johannesburg Water, Rand Water, njengoba sashilo umqhubi uhlelo, for allowing us to be part of the program. Namuhla ke nginiphathele incwadi, lena ncwadi ibizwa ukuthi How to Save Water, a Householder's Handbook. Who can tell me what this book is telling us? I saw that all of you are very, very clever. You already know what is in the book. Is there anyone who can tell me what is in the book? Did you read the book? Not yet. Okay. Uyabona ke namuhla ke ngiphathele zinengi incwadi, so nine nje lokune la, you are going to be ambassadors. You are going to be our ambassadors for this National Water Week. So what you do is, if you are an ambassador, you read what is in the book and then you help others also understand what is in the book. So le ncwadi is khombisa on how to save water.
Friends, we're still here at the Deep Slot Gym Park celebrating our National Water Week. And here with me, I'm with Mrs. Hlengiwe Xele from the Water Research Commission. Now, I'm more interested on this how to save water handbook. But before I ask you questions on that, I'm sure a lot of people back home are curious that as to what is the Water Research Commission?
The Water Research Commission is an institution that does research for South Africa. We're looking at different water issues, water challenges like the water use in agriculture, water use in industries, water use at home, domestic water use. We look at a lot of issues and do research that informs South Africa on what needs to be done around a lot of other things that relate to water.
So with this, I know this handbook is part of your initiative on how to educate the general public on how to save water. So how many of these books, of these rather handbooks, have you distributed?
This book actually has been developed by the commission for supporting the communities in an initiative for South Africa to save water, as we know that we are in a drought situation. So we thought maybe to start at home is the basic thing to do, so that if we start saving the water at home, then it's easy when we go out. So the book was developed, and mainly it is launched. It has been launched during the National Water Week. Starting last week, we distributed over 500 copies at Ivory Park. Yeah, so here today, we also issued books to the community development workers who are mainly doing door-to-door campaigns. So it's also over 500 copies that were distributed today to the communities of Diepsloot.
No, that's fantastic work. Absolutely wonderful work.
Yeah.
So are there any other programs that you'll be running during our National Water Week?
We have developed a lot of initiatives. For us, it's not only the National Water Week. We go beyond the National Water Week. What we do is we always raise the awareness around the issues relating to water in different aspects. And it also depends on different target groups that we communicate with. For instance, it's not only the communities, we also go out to other people, like other segments of society, and inform them about the need to step up. For instance, the decision makers. We help the policy makers in refining their policies such that it benefits the country. So there are a lot of communication activities that take place during this National Water Week.
Absolutely amazing. So if our friends back home want to find out more about the Water Research Commission, how can they get a hold of you? Do you have a website or email?
We have an open website that can be used by anyone that is seeking information. For instance, people can just log onto our website and download the reports as free as they. We don't make people pay for our reports. They are just we have an open source policy, if I may say so. They can download their reports, and our website is searchable. If you log onto our website and you type any keyword, so you are able to actually download any report that talks to what you are looking for. It has helped a lot of people, students in universities, they access information because we started operating as early as 1971. So you can imagine how much information we have on our website.
If you seek more information on all that's been happening here today, you know what to do. Visit our Facebook page, that is facebook.com/adbook. Alternatively, you can visit us on our website, that is www.adbook.co.za. I know you want to be the best, so never relax, never relax. Really? Take your dream high. What's up, buddy? Please. Yes. I know your fears hold you back. Don't fall for that trap. Come on, come on. Take your dream higher. Yeah. This year in faith, look up.